Greetings, ladies and the gentlemen who may be watching. Welcome to Marketing Makeovers. I'm marketing speaker Jim Ackerman, and this is the program where we show you how to get more customers who will pay you more money more often, and how you can selectively breed your sales, marketing, and advertising for ever-increasing success. This is actually program number one of a series of programs where we're going to take a look at just two one-page sales letters. One-page sales letters indeed. And ladies, I think you'll like them because they do have to do with the jewelry industry. But they're one-page sales letters jam-packed with 18 vital lessons you need to know if you want to increase response to your advertising and send profits through the roof. Well, as you can tell, we've shifted to my office, what I like to call my marketing laboratory. And I want to give you a little bit of background about these two letters. They were created by a client of mine who's gone through my coaching program. She's a jeweler in Elkin, North Carolina. And when she first engaged my services as her marketing coach, she had already begun to put together her Mother's Day promotion and committed to send out 65,000 flyers to all the folks in her surrounding area. And the cost of that was going to be $4,004 or 16 cents a piece. I said, that's fine, but do me a favor. Also send out 250 letters to 250 of your very best customers, special invitations just for them. I recommended that she do that, and she put them together in an invitation size envelope. It looked very much like an invitation. She hand addressed them and sent them out. Well, of the 65,000 flyers that went out, she had a little over a third of a percent response rate. Of the 250 letters that she sent out at a cost of 80 cents a piece, or $200 to send out the 250, she had a 45% response rate. That's right, 110 folks came and about 75 of them bought, generating $17,000 worth of revenue from just her list of 250 good customers. What about the revenue generated from the flyers? Well, about 54 people came and accounted for around $10,000 worth of revenue. Now, with that success in mind, Pat went and sent the following two sales letters, one to a list of but 186 people and another to a list of 400 people. And now begins the lessons. Lesson number one is, when you find something that works, keep doing it. The letter that you're looking at right now is the direct result of the very first letter that Pat sent to just 250 of her best clients. It worked so well that within 3 weeks she was back in the mail again, this time to 400 of her best clients with this particular letter, and the results were almost as stunning. Lesson number two is similar to lesson number one. Lesson number two is go home. Go home to your house list. It's almost always more profitable to market to your house list than it is to market to the general public. Pat found this out in her first mailing when she mailed just 250 pieces to her house list versus the 65,000 to everybody in the community. Spend the bulk of your revenue marketing to your house list. The next biggest portion should go to joint venture partnerships where you are marketing to the house lists of other non-competing businesses who share your similar type of customer, and then the general public from there. And if the time comes to cut your marketing budget, do so in reverse order. Cut your general marketing budget first, then your joint venture marketing budget, and save your house list marketing budget for last. Lesson number three, list segmentation is a hidden key to unprecedented profits. Look at these two letters. They look pretty identical, but they're not the same. Pat sent them simultaneously to different segments of her list. When was the last time you conducted two events at the same time? When's the last time you generated double-digit response rates from both of them? Pat did it, and this is why. You see, Pat's no longer worried about getting to everybody. She knows there's plenty of time for that. Pat's now playing small ball. How does she do that? List segmentation. She sends promotions to portions of her list that have specific interests. So as you can see by looking at the two letters, Pat thought of a promotion that would be a winner for some of her best customers, 400 of them in fact. Then she realized she has this group of elite clients who buy one particular brand of fine silver bee jewelry. So she sent the second letter only to those customers who had bought camellia pieces from her in the past. It had to be a hit. They were already hooked on the product. The right product to the right people at the right time with the right offer. It's the no-lose scenario. Now let's take a look at lesson number 4. Presentation matters. Let's take a look at the envelope that these letters came in. First, you should know that all the envelopes that Pat sent these letters in are the same, regardless of which letter was sent. You'll notice that they're not the standard number 10 business envelope. They're an A6 or announcement size. They're not emblazoned with the company logo above the return address. They're not inkjet address. There's no bulk postage, either printed or stamped. There's no teaser copy in the envelope pronouncing loudly to the recipient that this is business mail trying to get them to part with their hard-earned money. Instead, you see an envelope that looks like a greeting card or invitation. Yes, first-class postage is expensive compared to bulk rates, and I'm also sure that it hasn't escaped your attention that this envelope was handwritten. Actually, Pat saved money by doing that in a way, in that she had people sitting around her store anyway that had time on their hands. Why not have them write the envelopes? Why? Because when you look at this envelope, it screams, "Open me." It doesn't look like business mail in size, color, or presentation. It looks personal. The first and only job of the envelope is to get opened. That's lesson number 4. Now, while we're talking about presentation matters, let's go on to lesson number 5, because beauty is more than skin deep. Let's take a look at the presentation of the letters themselves. The first thing to note is that size matters. These are not 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper folded down to fit in the envelope. They're also not the standard personal stationery size that your mama sends her thank you cards on. They're 11 inches long to accommodate the length of the letter. If Pat had written a longer letter, she could have opted to put part of it on the back of the sheet, or she could have made the sheet as long as 14 inches. If she had written a shorter letter, it might have fit on the standard personal stationery, and that would have been fine. It's important to note that Pat did not adjust the length of her letter to fit the stationery. She adjusted the stationery to fit the length of her letter. Copy should drive design. Note the top of the letter. Again, no logo, just the announcement from the desk of Pat Prim. So far, we're staying personal, aren't we? The only problem I have here is the handwritten name in the salutation. This should have been done with a mail merge. It's ironic that the handwriting actually makes this thing look mass-produced. But the salutation and the entire letter are composed in courier type, the typewriter font, and that keeps it looking personal. Finally, the first name is used, followed by a comma. No dear friend or even dear Mr. Ackerman, and no colon, the punctuation of business letters, not personal letters. That's well done. And now lesson number 6. It's all about headlines and offers. You know, every ad has a headline, whether you recognize it or not, and the same is true of letters. Take a look at the headline here. It could be a line, it could be a paragraph. In this particular case, it's the first 2 paragraphs. What can you say about this headline? Here's my take. This headline has all 3 of the key elements that make a great headline: self-interest, news value, and curiosity. Think about it. I know when you read this, you're going to question my sanity, invokes the curiosity of the reader. Here's what I'm up to, introduces news value. I'm offering you an 18-inch strand of freshwater pearls, normally $89.95, value for just $29.95, delivers the self-interest and a compelling offer. Hard to get anything any better. That is a compelling headline. Well, we've been through 6 lessons on this one little one-page letter, and I promised you 18. We can't get it all done in one program, unfortunately, so you'll just have to stay tuned for the next editions of Marketing Makeovers. Meanwhile, if you'd like a complete report on all 18 of these lessons delivered right to you in the form of my Marketing Wizards Alliance newsletter, please send me an email at mail@ascendmarketing.com, and I'd be happy to send it to you, along with a complete audio program that describes everything in detail. You can listen to it in your car. That's it for now, and we'll see you next time on Marketing Makeovers.